Welcome students to class 5 maths chapter 4 factors and multiples session 4.5. Today we will do application of HCF and LCM. Example 1. Find the least number which is exactly divisible by 9, 12 and 18. So here you will have to concentrate on the word least. Wherever the word least is used, you have to find out the LCM, least common factor. Let us find the LCM of 9, 12 and 18. We will do it by the long division method. First, we will divide by 2. 9 doesn't divide, so 9 we will copy as it is. And 12 and 18, we will write 6 and 9 respectively. Now, again, we have 6. 6 divides by 2. So, we will again divide by 2. And we will write 9, 3, 3. Only 6 divides by 2, so we have written 3. Rest of the numbers, that is 9 and 9, we have copied as it is. Now, none of them divide by 2. So, we check the next prime number, which is 3. So, all of them divide by 3. So, we write 3, we divide, we get 3, 1, 3. Again, we will divide by 3, we get 1, 1, 1. Now, at the stage where we get 1, 1, 1, we have to stop. For LCM, we'll have to multiply these numbers. So, LCM of 9, 12 and 18 will be 2 into 2 into 3 into 3, which is equal to 36. So that means we have to write 36 is the least number divisible by 9, 12 and 18. In the table of 9, 36 will come. In the table of 12, 36 will come. And in the table of 18, 36 will come. Example 2. Find the greatest number which is divisible by 18 and 24 exactly. Now here the word greatest. From greatest, you have to understand. Greatest means highest and highest common factor. Let us find the HCF of 18 and 24. We will do it by division method. We'll write 24 inside and 18 on the outside of the division symbol. It will go one time. When we subtract, we will get 6. And then we'll again draw a division symbol and bring this 18 inside the division symbol. We will divide 18 by 6. It will go 3 times. We'll get 0. At this stage where we get 0 remainder, the divisor is our HCF. Students know they have to stop when they get 0 remainder. I have seen children get confused which is the HCF. This 3 is the HCF, 6 is the HCF, or this 18 is the HCF. So you have to remember the stage at which you get 0 remainder, that divisor. That divisor is 6. So that is the HCF. Don't get confused with all the other numbers that are written around. Okay. Only this number is your HCF. So 6 is your HCF. 6 is the greatest number which divides 18 and 24 exactly. Students, remember I had made a video on tricks to find the LCM and tricks to find the HCF. Thereby in the HCF, I had missed out one small trick. When a prime number is involved in the list of numbers where we have to find HCF. Now supposing 19 and 24 would have been given to us. Now I want you to pause the video. Use the long division method. Find the HCF of 19 and 24. Write it in the comment section with your name. And unpause the video after you have written the comment. I am sure you would have got the answer as 1. So, you have to remember this. If you are given a set of numbers and you have to find the HCF, and in that set of numbers, there is a prime number involved, then the HCF of those numbers is going to be 1. Now, we are ready to do worksheet 4.5. Question 1. Two big packets of books contain 72 and 96 books respectively. These books are to be packed into small packets which will contain same number of books. How many maximum number of books can be packed in each small packet? So here the question tells you there are two big packets of books. One packet contains 72 books, the other packet is containing 96 books. Now from these big packets, the books have to be put in small packets. They want us to find out how many maximum number of books can be packed in each small packet. So, now concentrate on the word maximum. Whenever the word maximum comes, we have to find out the highest common factor. Okay, next question. The students of two classes are supposed to stand in rows having same number of students. There are 35 and 49 students in each class. How many maximum number of students will stand in each row? Here they are telling us the number of students in two classes, that is one is 35, one is 49. And how many maximum number of students will stand in each row? The word maximum. Maximum, I had given you a hint. Maximum will mean we have to find the highest common factor. So again in this question you will find the HCF. Now another way to solve this question. First, I will tell you the concepts that you already know. A factor of a number is either equal to that number or less than that number. And multiple of a number is equal to that number or greater than that number. So, factor we take out when we want a smaller number. Multiple we take out when we want a bigger number. Now, in this case, you have 35 and 49 students and you have to make them stand in rows. In each row, you will have students less than 35 and 49. So you are looking for a smaller number as your answer. For a smaller number, you have to take out factors. Thus, you will take out HCF, that is highest common factor, to get your answer. Question 3. Three bells ring at an interval of 20, 25 and 30 minutes. If they all ring at 12 noon together, at what time will they next ring together? Now here, what will you concentrate on? They have told us three bells ring at every 20 minutes, then the second bell rings at every 25 minutes and the third bell rings after every 30 minutes. And at 12 noon, all three of them rang together. So which is the next earliest time that they will ring again together? So concentrate on this part. At what time will they next ring together? Basically, they're talking about when it will be ring next at the earliest. The at the earliest concept comes, that means the minimum time. Minimum means least. So where the word minimum, at the earliest or least comes, you have to find the least common multiple or the LCM. So you will find the LCM of these three numbers. Now one more explanation of what to do in a particular question. The concept, if you want a smaller number as an answer, you take out factors. If you want a bigger number as answer, you take out the multiples. So now here, the bell is ringing after 20 minutes, 25 minutes and 30 minutes. So for that bell to ring again, it will not ring again together after 20 or 25 or 30 minutes. It is very evident that it is going to be a longer time frame. So you want a bigger number as answer. When you need a bigger number as answer, you will have to find out the multiples. Thus, you will find the least common multiple or the LCM to get your answer. Question 4. What is the least number of apples a teacher should have so that when he distributes equal number of them to his 10, 15 and 25 students, no apple is left with him? Here you will concentrate on the word least. Least will mean least common multiple. So you will find the LCM of 10, 15 and 25 here. Now pause the video. Solve all the questions. And once you finish the solution, unpause and see solutions to worksheet 4.5. Question 1. Two big packets of books contain 72 and 96 books respectively. These books are to be packed into small packets which will contain same number of books. How many maximum number of books can be packed in each small packet? The facts given to us is books contained in the first big packet, 72. Then books contained in the second big packet, which is equal to 96. Now we read the last part of the question. How many maximum number of books can be packed in each small packet? So from here you will make the next statement. Number of maximum books in each small packet. For this you will find the HCF of 72 and 96. Why the HCF? Because maximum number has to be found. Maximum will be found when we find the highest common factor. So we will do it by division method. We write 96 inside, 72 outside. 72 will go one time. When we subtract, we get 24. And then we again draw this symbol and bring this 72 inside. Then 24 will go three times. We'll write 3 on the outside, 72. At the bottom, subtract, we get 0. Now at the stage where we get 0, that divisor, don't confuse it with the other numbers that are written. Only the divisor at the stage where you get 0, that is going to be your HCF. So HCF of 72 and 96 is 24. Answer will be 24 books. Question 2. The students of two classes are supposed to stand in rows having same number of students. There are 35 and 49 students in the classes. How many maximum number of students will stand in each row? As discussed earlier, we have to find the HCF of 35 and 49. Why HCF? Because the number of students in one row is going to be less than 35 and 49. That means we are looking for a smaller number as answer. And to get a smaller number, we have to find factors. We will find the highest common factor. And this term maximum also indicates that we have to find the highest common factor. Now first we'll write the information given to us. Students in first class is equal to 35. Students in second class is equal to 49. Now we'll go back to the question and see what we have to find out. How many maximum number of students will stand in each row? So we will write maximum number of students in each row is equal to HCF of 35 and 49. Then we'll find out the HCF by the division method. 35 will go once. We subtract, we get 14 as the remainder. Then we draw a division symbol and bring down this 35 inside the symbol. 14 will go 2 times, 28, we subtract, we are left with 7. Then we'll draw a division symbol and bring down this 14. 7 will go 2 times in 14, 7 2s are 14, and we are left with 0 remainder. So this divisor at the stage where we got 0 remainder is the HCF. So HCF of 35 and 49 is 7. Therefore, answer is 7 students. Question 3. 3 bells ring at an interval of 20, 25 and 30 minutes. If they all ring at 12 noon together, at what time will they next ring together? So as discussed earlier, this is a question where we will get a bigger number than 30 as the answer. The bells will not ring simultaneously after 20 minutes or 25 minutes or 30 minutes. It has to be a bigger number when they will all ring together. For a bigger number, we have to find the multiple. Multiples would be least common multiple. First, we will write the information given to us. First bell rings after an interval of 20 minutes. Then, second bell rings after an interval of 25 minutes. Followed by, third bell rings at an interval of 30 minutes. After this, we will look at the question again. If they all ring at 12 noon, at what time will they next ring together? So, we have to now find the time at which they are next ringing together. They will ring together after an interval of, this is going to be equal to LCM of 20, 25 and 30. So we will find the LCM of 20, 25 and 30. We see that two numbers out of the three divide by 2. So first we'll divide by 2, we get 10, 25 and 15. 25 did not divide by 2, so we have copied it as it is. Now only 10 divides by 2, so we will again divide by 2. We write 5, 25, 15. Now none of them divide by 2, we go to the next prime number. Next prime number is 3. 5 doesn't divide by 3, 25 doesn't divide by 3, 15 divides by 3. So we will divide by 3. When we divide by 3, 5 and 25 will copy as it is and 15 will become 5. Now we go to the next prime number 5. We write 5, we get 1, 5 and 1. Now this again, there's only 1, 5 we have to settle. So we will divide by 5 again and now we are left with 1, 1, 1. So we stop at the stage where we get 1, 1, 1 and the LCM is the multiplication of all these numbers. So LCM of 20, 25 and 30 is 2 into 2 into 3 into 5 into 5, which is equal to 300. They will ring together after an interval of 300 minutes. They will ring together again at 12 noon plus 300 minutes. We divided 300 by 60. When we divide by 60, we get 5. So we write this is equal to 12 noon plus 5 hours, which is equal to 5 p.m. So the answer is 5 p.m. The bells will again ring together at 5 p.m. The least number of apples a teacher should have so that when he distributes equal number of them to his 10, 15 and 25 students, no apple is left with him. As discussed earlier, we have to find the least number. So in this question, we have to find LCM. So here the teacher has a fixed number of apples. First, he is distributing to 10 students. then he is distributing to 15 students, and then he is distributing to 25 students. So this fixed number has to come in the table of 10, has to come in the table of 15, and has to come in the table of 25. So that when he gives it to those many children, no apple is left. And such a number which comes in the table of all these three numbers is going to be greater than the numbers. Therefore, we will have to find least common multiple or LCM. So let us first put the information that is given to us. Students in first group 10, students in second group 15, students in third group 25. Now we have to find the minimum number of apples required. So that will be least common multiple of 10, 15 and 25. LCM of 10, 15 and 25. So we'll start dividing with 2. We get 5, 15, 25. Then we divide by 3. We get 5, 5, 25. Next we divide by 5. We get 1, 1 and 5. And then finally we again divide by 5 and we get all 1s. The product of these numbers is going to be our LCM. LCM of 10, 15, 25 is 2 into 3 into 5 into 5, which is equal to 150. Answer is 150 apples. This brings us to the end of the worksheet. Until we meet again, stay happy and keep learning.